I think the granting of anonymity, which they have said didn't come up front, it only came after they read the piece, verified the identity of the person, and were comfortable that this person knows what he or she is talking about. And then they weighed that against, would we be able to run this kind of a piece without the anonymity? And the answer clearly was no. And so I think that's the call they made. I think they really weighed the public interest in kind of knowing this. And in that sense, I think, at least to me personally, it feels like the value of this information outweighed the occasional granting of anonymity. So the use of a senior administration official is not uncommon. You'll find that in a lot of news stories as well when such anonymity is granted. And there's a reason why it's a little bit broader, because you don't want, after the fact, somebody being able to pinpoint that person. At the same time, you use it very deliberately because that person or what they've said has to be something that they have access to. They were in the room and they're part of that kind of proximity, in this case, to the President of the United States. So I think it was, I assume, thought through and covers a broad enough thing that you can't identify somebody, but is narrow enough to make sure that it's the person actually has firsthand knowledge of what's happening. If somebody writes and wants anonymity, but writes in such a way that people can identify who that person is, it shouldn't be up to the New York Times to give that extra layer of protection. It should be up to the writer to make sure that he or she is not outed. I think in news stories, they're clearly like a much higher threshold, and the only time you would want to do that is if that's the only way you can get a piece of information that is relevant and important, and it's kind of, you've vetted the source. In opinion writing, obviously there's a bit more of a leeway, but again, it's at the discretion of the op-ed editors at the Times. And again, they have really not, most newspapers have very rarely done it. Does it cause significant challenges to journalism? I think it adds, for example, the president has been very vocal about kind of classifying certain brands, particularly the New York Times, as fake news and false news. It gives him perhaps more ammunition to go to his base and say, I told you so. These people don't have even the courage to kind of tell me who my enemies are. So in that sense, that could reinforce the 30% of this country that might believe what he's saying. But I don't think that it is going to have any lasting impact on the New York Times or on journalism.